The Army is doing something about the weather.
Ah, yeah, I'm back, nigga. Yeah, I'm back, nigga. Fuck niggas is talking about. Fuck all that who the best shit, this and that. Y'all know what the fuck it is with me. Ah, the butcher coming, nigga. Yo, last year was about branding, this one about expanding.
What's up, all my devil dogs? It's your boy, Sean Otley, Strength Corps Zion 5-Star General. Okay, I know it's the first time I'm talking to you in this video. Not gonna make this super long. This is just kind of the intro into my new series. I have a meet coming up in January on the 9th or the 10th. It just depends. I think I'm gonna be lifting on the 10th actually, but regardless, it's the Boynton Barbell Championship. As you guys may or may not know, I recently moved to West Palm, which is close to Boynton, which is the gym I go to now. So I'm no longer living down south. As you can see, I have a whole new setup, some pretty dope stuff here in the background that maybe I'll make a video on someday. But right now I'm trying to, you know, give you guys a little motivation, give you guys a little peek into my meet prep, and get back to posting informative videos so you can apply what I put in my videos directly to your training, your nutrition, whatever it is you want to apply it to, depending on the topic of the video. So a couple quick things I want to go over. Number one, I wanted to go over what I've been doing in the off season. So basically the last, I would say 8 weeks or so, I have been focused on just my form, technique, you know, for the most part, and just kind of like more bodybuilding stuff. I've been trying to get stronger, but also trying to, you know, put on a little bit of size and also lose some weight. After the virus, you can't say the other thing, or, you know, anyways, after that happened and everything got shut down, I was 243 pounds, which was about 13 pounds over my weight class limit of 231. So I wanted to, you know, get on a little journey to lose some weight. I didn't make a series on it because I just kind of wanted to focus. And as of yesterday, I actually weighed in at 225, which is crazy because I stopped my diet about a week ago because I was around 229, 230. And I was like, okay, I'm cool here. I look good. I feel good. I don't want to keep, you know, pressing it. So I actually increased my calories. Cardio was still there and I continued to lose weight. Now that can be a topic for a different video, but I did accomplish my weight loss goal of 225, just, you know, kind of unexpectedly, but I was able to do that. What that's gonna allow me to do, as long as I can maintain that weight, is if I want to, I could water cut a little bit and be a little bit lower than my 231 weight class allows, and that'll actually allow me to get more IPF points because Wilkes is, I guess, out of the door now. But if you weigh less and lift more, then, you know, you get more points. So if I came in and lifted the same weights at 230 that I do at 225, I would get more points because I'm 5 pounds lighter at 225. So I'm gonna try and maintain around 225, 230. I'm not really gonna sweat it too much. That way when the meet comes around, I don't gotta worry about water cutting or anything like that. I did water cut for my last meet and that went okay, but it just would be a lot easier and smoother if that was just a variable I didn't have to worry about. So in my off season, that's what I focused on. There was also one thing that I started focusing on basically at the end of the 8 weeks. I've been dealing with some quad tendonitis for quite a while. If you follow the channel for a while, you know that I deal with that from time to time, and it was getting pretty bad. I actually hit up, his name's Dr. Joseph Rosie, Joey. He basically told me a couple of things about my form, about my mobility, that is gonna help my knee out. I'm actually gonna put that in a separate video that'll be after this one, kind of breaking that down. But it was time to really, you know, take the time to take care of my body, because lifting hundreds hundreds and hundreds of pounds is not normal. And I forget that sometimes being in the powerlifting realm where everybody's lifting 600, 700, 800 pounds, that, you know, even something like lifting 400 to 500 pounds or 500 to 600 pounds, which is about the range I'm in for my squats and deads now, it's not normal. Like, that is like really good. So, and really heavy. So I have to make sure I'm taking care of my body and just paying it a little more close attention and giving it a little TLC that I haven't been giving it in the past. So enough about what I did. You know, I did a little weight loss. I did my off season, started addressing some things here. What am I doing now for meat prep? Well, number one, I'm coaching myself. As you guys know, I wanted to coach myself. I think it was last year. I wanted to coach myself into the Ray Williams Classic in July, smashed my toes 2 weeks out, and that was the end of that. And just to help me rehab properly, I got my old coach Brendan back. We were working together. I had my meet in November, and since then I obviously haven't had any meets because, you know, everything's been kind of closed and limited and shut down due to the, you know, current state of the world. But I do have my eyes set on January 9th/10th to have my next meet. It'll be crazy because 2020 I didn't compete at all, but we're just gonna throw 2020 out the we're just gonna throw 2020 to the side. We're just gonna pretend like this year never happened anyway. So the fact that I didn't compete in 2020, nobody's even gonna remember it, because nobody's gonna wanna remember 2020. So my goals going into this meet, I'm not gonna give you guys numbers. I'd rather just keep you surprised and keep you watching to see how I perform. And based off of that, maybe you can get some guesses, but I do have some numbers in mind that I wanna hit. And I think that I can accomplish those. And I think I could really accomplish some big numbers on my squat and deadlift if I can get some of this mobility and some of this, you know, tendinopathy to go down, which I think I will be able to get in under control by the time the meet comes, and, you know, perform very well and do very good. So I'm looking forward to that. Also, quick little update for those of you who do know or may not know, I'm also in the process of becoming a firefighter, and I have my practice test on the 1st of November and then the actual test on the 15th of November to get into the Fire Academy. So I'm gonna try and get that on video as best I can and then put that on the channel for you guys. Some of you guys are pretty invested in watching me in that journey and not just on my fitness journey. So I'll be posting those videos here. Will I make a firefighter channel at some point? I don't know, maybe, but I need to focus on you guys, my strength core. That is my number one focus, my number one goal. We've been here for years and I never plan on leaving you guys. I might go a little while without posting a video, but just know that I will always be back. All right, last but not least, gonna reiterate, I have so many great ideas for videos, and I'm going to kind of take a leap of faith and just start recording them, because a lot of times what stops me from posting is not that I don't have the time. I just really want to do so much for my videos, and sometimes I have to realize that you guys really just like the cold, hard info and information. And if I just sat here and literally gave you the information with maybe a couple of like graphs or maybe some studies or whatever, maybe some slight video clips, that you guys would love that, and I don't have to get all stupid crazy with the editing. So that's really, you know, holding myself accountable. That's what's kind of held me back from making a lot of videos. It's not hard to set my camera up and talk to you guys. I can literally talk forever. Ask anybody who's ever met me. I can literally just go on all day. But a lot of times when it comes to my videos, what stops me is I'm just like, okay, I don't want to just be talking to you guys. But I listen to a lot of that content. I listen to plenty of podcasts and plenty of videos. I don't even watch them. I just listen to them for the information. So I'm sure a lot of you guys out there would appreciate that. So that's my commitment to you guys, is not limiting myself based off of trying to do all these crazy edits, but just getting you good information that you can then apply to your training or nutrition or whatever topic I happen to cover in that video, and help you guys to become better lifters, athletes, people, all that good stuff. All right, so I don't make this video too long. If you enjoyed today's video, be sure to subscribe. Leave a thumbs up down below, really helps the channel grow. Also, don't forget to click that bell next to the subscription button so you get notifications for all my new videos. And of course, don't forget the orders. That was weird. That was hella weird. Hold on. Don't forget the orders. Subscribe and share. Like and comment. Follow all my social media. Hold up. I always mess this up. Every time I don't record for a while, I mess this up. Okay. I think when I make that, it's on this side. I'm pretty sure it's on this. I always mess this up. I'm gonna try not to. Now I gotta do it all over. Don't forget the orders. Subscribe and share, like and comment, follow all my social media. Till next time, all my devil dogs, dismissed. Back tripping on these niggas.
This life expensive, so we always trying to get it. I can't quit, intact remains the vision. I can catch my own fish, I could put you on shit.